good morning to you guys. Shocker, we're in the
good morning.
Today we are doing the worst of the worst. And what I'm talking about is the roads. Per everybody warning us, the book, the comments, the internet, everybody's like, woo, be careful going through there. So you know when the GPS tells us it's gonna be 4 hours that we're like, yeah, try seven. We're in the truck, driving, because that's what we're doing. We're on our way to Alaska. You guys know this. Where we last left you off, we were just about finished the Cassiar Highway, but that next day we finished our drive all the way to Whitehorse, where we spent a few days getting work done. Rainey and I did laundry. We got some groceries. Whitehorse basically is the only city in the Yukon Territory, and it's also the capital. There's a lot of resources in Whitehorse, and one of the best resources we found was cellular internet. We found a coffee shop in town that the cell signal was, oh my gosh, so good. We were able to get our video uploaded and do all the stuff we gotta do for the channel. I will say, Starlink, We've been talking about how it's been working at some places in British Columbia where we're in the middle of nowhere, but we went to the Yukon thinking same thing. And it was like cutting in and out. It was very weird because instead of saying obstructions, it was just showing, like, it was searching for a satellite. And what we discovered is that there's not many satellites in the area, like floating in the sky above the Yukon Territory. We're gonna keep you posted on how Starlink does up here, because I know a lot of you guys are thinking of doing Canada and Alaska, and you have Starlink and you're concerned about working remotely. Listen, we got you covered. So just sit back, just listen, put your feet up. I know you might be sitting on the couch right now. Kick your feet up, put your beverage next to you. We're gonna take you for a ride. It's gonna be bumpy. Okay. Today we're gonna be driving through Destruction Bay. We're heading up to Toke.
Destruction Bay, what a fitting name.
Yeah, you ain't kidding. I'm now understanding why they came up with that name. Now, we just did the Stewart-Cassiar Highway all the way through British Columbia, so we know how those roads are. Will this be worse? Only time will tell. The Hanks are always up for a good challenge. You know that there's been many roads that everyone's like, don't drive on this road, this road's awful, this road, that road. Well, we went on them to test them out, and we've done it in several videos. I think we did I-10, I-95. Basically, just watch all of our videos because we find ourselves on interesting roads and situations a lot. We haven't even hit the worst of it yet. I thought this was gonna be like a warm up for 2 hours. We just left Whitehorse area and we're not even close to Destruction Bay yet, and it's already bumpy. I-75 might be a breeze after this.
See, if you guys didn't believe already that the Hanks are not up for a challenge, we did one up it. So Nene is currently driving. I'm taking the passenger seat and I'm being the navigation person, the navigation station situation going on. You guys are gonna be in for a real treat here soon. Am I worried about Destruction Bay? I'm glad you guys asked. Not really.
Do you guys need medical? Do you guys need medical help?
We need a doctor.
We're ER nurses.
Probably gonna eat my own words on that one. It was only a month or two ago that we were rocking our trailer down back roads of Arizona. We're talking miles of desolate roads with washboard abs, basically. The road was really in shape and ripped, and it was taking a toll on the trailer. So whatever Destruction Bay is ready to throw at us, I'm sure we can handle it just fine.
It's not Destruction Bay that's bad. It's the road between Destruction Bay. Who am I kidding? Maybe Destruction Bay is bad as well. I don't know.
I mean, maybe Toke exists because when people get there, they toke a lot about Destruction Bay and stuff. That was a stretch. It was a stretch. I had to try for the dad joke. I went for it. You gotta give me credit for at least trying, right? No? What? Come on. Where's the enthusiasm here? Let's go, Carl. Do I ever get nervous when Nene drives? Actually, quite the opposite. She's an amazing driver. She's really good at navigating. So I feel like all the skills as a captain are kind of honed into one person. And don't tell her I said this, but she's pretty good at what she does.
Do you want to get married?
Sure. When were you thinking? You name the date and I'll be there. Now you may be asking yourself, Hanks, you're always driving. You're constantly just sitting in the truck and you're driving. And you know what? You're absolutely correct. This is the story of our lives. But let me clarify a little bit on that, because I was very naive to how things worked up north of the United States. I'm thinking that's a hop and a skip to Alaska. Things are gonna be easy peasy lemon squeezy, and we're gonna be there in no time. Do you guys truly understand the plethora, the vastness of Canada? Because I didn't. Whoa, that's a long drive. So what better way to bring you guys into this environment with us and keep it refreshing and real? Listen, we were nervous and we still are nervous for what's to come. So we want to document that for you guys and help you to prepare mentally for what is in the journey and on the horizon for y'all. I get it. That may not be good enough reason. And you're like, Carl, I'm still not buying it. I want out of this truck. Well, you know what? So do I. So do I. So let's go.
Carl, no! You just gave me a heart attack that scared me so much I thought we were crashing.
Was that a little too far? Everyone's like, Carl, you can't do that while someone's driving. That is very dangerous. Well, dang it, Hanks. We like to live on the edge. Listen, we're alive. It's okay. We're gonna be okay. But these bumps coming up, holy mackerel. Look at these frost heaves. Honey, I am so sorry for what I did and what I just said a few minutes ago. That wasn't me. That was Carl. This is Kyle here right now. It's Kyle, your husband. What in tarnation is a frost heave? Well, let me clarify. A frost heave is when the ground freezes and then it thaws out. And over time, it takes a toll on the roads and creates like huge, almost waves in the roads itself. It's not necessarily like a bump, but it's like a hump. You following what I'm saying? It's a frost heave.
It's a frost heave, not a frost hoe. You know, if it were like this, we'd be heave ho. Go ahead.
That's what I was thinking too. Don't mind her. She thinks she's funny. She thinks I married her because of her humor. I kind of did, but
I'll be over here if you need me.
Now let me lay it out for you. What are some of our biggest concerns going on this road today? Well, one thing being we did not bring extra parts. I had heard through the grapevine from many other friends in comments below saying you should bring some extra parts. Like extra leaf springs in case you damage one. There's not a lot of resources as we go further north. Did the Hanks do that? Of course we didn't. We keep it super real because who has the time to do all this planning? You just want to go to Alaska. You just want to get it done. I ain't going to reach out to 20 different people looking for leaf springs, extra tires, extra this, extra that. Listen, we adapt and overcome as things happen. So strap in. It's going to be a real one. If I had to ask you one thing that you're super nervous about right now driving on these roads, lay it out on me, girl, because I need to hear it from your lips.
I guess it would be hitting a bump so hard that things break inside the RV. When we got to one of our boondocking spots a few nights ago, the trim underneath the back cabinets was like coming down. That was the Stewart Cassier Highway, so maybe that's the worst it will be. I'm prepared to just slow it down from a distance. What is that?
We survived the Cassier Stewart Highway. So many people were saying, you better be prepared, Hanks. Have auxiliary tanks. Have this, have that. And look, we did the exact same thing as we're doing right now. We did not prepare whatsoever. We did a little bit of research, but we went for it. And guess what? No worse than what we had to deal with in the States. When we're driving through Death Valley, it says the next fuel station is so many miles away, you better fuel up, and that's exactly how it is up here. So we just followed those same rules and we got it done. Keep common sense towards the forefront of your mind and prepare for little things that might happen. Maybe gas stations run out of fuel, but guess what? You have a little extra water on hand, you could throw up your camper in the back and be like, I'm just gonna camp here overnight until the resources come about again. I'm not saying that happens a lot, but look, adapt and overcome.
The roads are okay, but they're gonna get worse. I know it.
I'm telling you what, you can't beat these views. This is like literally the most beautiful thing I've ever seen. See, before we were initially gonna go to Switzerland, but guess what? The Alps are here in Canada and Alaska. Like, you don't have to go very far from home. You kind of do, but you don't have to fly over an ocean to get those views. Yeah, see, this is what we ran into with the Stuart Cassier Highway. There were sections where it was a little bit of a dirt road, but overall, not super bad. It's not these roads that I'm concerned about because you can go super slow. It's the frost heaves coming up that I'm really concerned about because that's where they're unexpected. Now, I heard that they try to mark them on the road, I believe, right?
My thing is I'm not concerned about the frost heaves because they have, there's ample warning. You'll okay. see like cones and you know it's coming, so you know to slow down.
What about the new frost heaves, hun? Like, there's new ones out there that might not have been discovered. We can discover them, and like the stars, we can name them.
All right, comment below what we should call our first frost heave that we're gonna discover.
I think we cannot go wrong with naming the first frost heave something like Let It Rip.
Let me rip these leaf springs off your RV.
That's exactly what I mean. That would be a sweet name for a star, too. Just throwing that out there. If we find a star, we're going to name it Let It Rip.
Now, those people that just passed us, yeah, those are the people that should carry extra parts.
Listen, if you ever feel rushed, don't forget, slow down and just let people pass.
I think what you got to take into consideration is just being aware. Like, when people warn you about the roads being bad, it's just take your driving a little bit more into consideration. Like, you're going to be more hyper aware of potholes. You're going to be not as laid back, and you just know that it's going to take you more time to get where you need to go. Versus if you're just on a normal drive day, you're just hanging back and you're just hitting potholes because you're not really looking for them.
See, the thing of it is people take these things at their own pace, and that's totally fine. Other RVers may be feeling more comfortable going at a certain speed on the road. We have nowhere to be. We want to take our time and enjoy the beauty of Alaska. Who knows when next time we're going to come up this way. So let's enjoy it for what it is. But in all seriousness though, I hope that helps you guys feel a little more at ease when you're on the road. Don't feel pressured by other people. Nobody really cares about what you're doing. They only care about themselves. So just take your time, do things at your own pace, and you're going to be good to go. And if you're still not convinced and you're a little nervous, send him our way, because you know what? We got a salty britches back in the back seat here. He'll take care of them. Don't be fooled by his sleeping nature right now. He's a salty, frisky, ferocious kitty. He'll take things into his own hands, or should I say paws. That was a honker, holy mackerel. That was the biggest one yet.
That was the biggest heave-ho we've seen.
Let's keep our heave-hos to a minimum.
Okay.
Oh my goodness, that was like a crater. Like, you just went through a crater.
Yeah, that was like truck stop.
That was like truck stop level. What we mean by truck stop level is, if you ever go to a truck stop, like a TA, Petro, Loves, get out there where all the truckers are in the Netherlands. They have these potholes from 1978 that they just have never addressed. They just let it go, and they just are going to continue letting it go. Don't go out there. It is no man's land. It's horrible. All right, there's like a rest area in 2 kilometers. You guys still good to push on through, or do you need to stop? No need to be busting out salty attitudes. We're fine. Thank you very much. You really couldn't pick a better spot than this to just stop and pull over. We're like, why didn't we find this before and boondock there? Wow. That's all I can say, guys. I can only say wow. There's no other words for this. Unless you're here feeling the wind and just seeing this for yourself, it's just wow. That's all I can say. The coolest part is we pulled over and we met some friends here that follow us along with the journey with you guys as well. They just recently got full time on the road too, and it is just cool to see it come to life for you guys. We are ecstatic to hear about you guys getting out on the road and just enjoying life for what it is. That's what it's all about.
Where are we stopping?
Destruction Bay.
Okay.
Causing destruction.
You want to stop at Destruction Bay?
Yeah.
So this was a stretch of legs and get back on the road?
Yes.
Well, what are we doing? Let's get back on the road.
Let's do it.
Let's do it.
Back on the road.
Back on the road.
Cross tubes. Oh, I'm driving.
That's bad voodoo. Do not wish that upon us.
Next stop, Destruction Bay. Carl's not nervous. We got this. Because we have you guys,
anything's possible.
So we're gonna stop and get some fuel because as we made the agreement before we started this trip, we're not gonna bypass fuel stations except for that one time we did it on the Cassier Highway. That was a once and done, but now no more. We're about a half a tank right now. We need some diesel. And as we're pulling in, I wanna say, make sure you always watch those height clearances because on the left-hand side, it's saying 12'6". And on the right-hand side, it's saying 14'6". Just really be careful. You never know what you're pulling into. Nobody's here to help, so.
Do you guys need medical? Do you guys need medical help?
We need a doctor.
We're ER nurses.
Come on over.
Here we go.
Guys, we're gonna help.